Ya, assalamualaikum and good afternoon. Okay, I hope you all will be ready for our next lecture, lecture 9. It's still on the same topic, which is economic assessment, which focusing on the appraisal techniques. Okay, before we start, yesterday we have there are five methods involved or five methods involved in applying the appraisal techniques. Applying the appraisal techniques. Okay, yesterday we have covered three methods, which are NPV, IRR, and also MIRR. Alright, so today we are going, which the three methods that we covered last week is more on the what we call it as a discounting discounting methods of evaluations. Alright, so while today the other two that we are going to focus is more on traditional methods of evaluations, okay, which consists of two methods, payback period and also accounting rate of return. Okay, so that's what we are going to cover today. Can you see the slide?
Yes.
All right.
Boleh,
sir. Wait, ada yang baru nak join. Okay, as I mentioned just now, we are still in the same topic, economic assessment. Okay, we have covered last week on the introduction on capital expenditure and capital budgeting, which we more emphasize on capital budgeting, on especially on how we can evaluate the option that we have in our business or in our companies. All right. Lagi nak join? Lepas tu saya suruh join awal, interrupt my lecture, problem sikit. Alright, so I've mentioned yesterday and also just now, we have five methods regarding the appraisal techniques. Okay, we have covered three, NPV, IRR and also MIRR. Okay, anyone have did the exercise that I gave you yesterday? Ada yang dah try buat, ada a few of you yang PM me asking how to solve one of the questions. Maybe some of you have tried lah, but never mind. For those who are not trying, who are not yet trying to answer the exercise, you can do after this session, and we're going to discuss the answer next week lah. Okay, but I hope you can try it first. Okay, because if you don't try the exercises, you cannot see how you can apply what we have learned yesterday and also today. Okay, so today we are going to cover another method, another two methods, which are payback period and also accounting rate of return. Okay, so as a recap, remember this rule of thumb. Okay, yesterday we have go through three method until IRR. So today we're going to cover another two, which is payback period. So how the selection rules regarding payback period is that if you the results of payback period is less than target period, okay, we can accept that proposal or that project. If more than target period, we need to reject. But if equals to target period, means it's indifference. Okay, so in that case, is you can go for it or you can ignore or reject the project as well. Okay, so means payback period ni the shorter the better lah. Okay, later on we are going to have a look more detail about it. And the last method that we are going to go through today is about ARR, okay, accounting rate of return. Okay, if we can accept the proposal or project if the ARR value is more than target rate, or we can reject the proposal or the project if ARR is less than target rate. Okay, if equals is indifferent, so again, a similar concept is either you go for it or you reject. You reject the proposal. Okay, both are acceptable. Alright. So for these two methods, payback period and accounting rate of return is more on the what we call it as a traditional methods of evaluation technique. Okay, yesterday we have learned about discounting method of evaluation. Okay, more on what we call it as improvisation from traditional method of evaluation. Okay, so first method under this traditional method of evaluation is known as payback period. Okay, so what is payback period? Okay, it's involved calculating how long it takes for a project to repay its original invested capital. Okay, so we are not looking on how long you can get the profit. Okay, we are looking at how long it takes for you to get your profit, to get your capital back. Okay, modal yang kita dah laburkan tu, berapa lama masa diperlukan untuk kita dapat balik. Okay, that's what we call it as a payback period. Okay, let's say example yesterday, I give you, we invested RM9,000. Okay, RM9,000 tu. Okay, so kita nak tahu berapa lama kita boleh dapat balik RM9,000 tu. Setahun ke, dua tahun ke, tiga tahun ke. So that's why we can apply what we call it as a payback period. Okay, so as I mentioned earlier, the shorter the payback period, the greater is the likelihood that the project will be profitable. Okay, so makin cepat kita dapat balik modal kita, makin bagus untuk kita go for that project. Okay, so that's what we call it as a payback period. Another methods under the traditional methods of evaluation technique is called as accounting rate of return. Typo ARR katanya. ARR, but sometimes called as average annual rate of return. Okay, this method involves calculating the average return and expressing it as a percentage of the invested capital. Okay, we are looking at what we call it as profit that we can get, potential profit that we can get from the investment that we did previously. Okay, let's say tadi for example, like we invest RM9,000, so how much we can get? From that, if we want to know how much we can get, we can apply what we call it as a accounting rate of return. Okay, this is the formula of accounting rate of return. Equals income divided by investment times N. N is numbers of years. Kalau 10 tahun lah, 5 years lah, times 100%. Okay, so for these two methods, is quite direct. Okay, not that as complicated as yesterday lah. Okay, yesterday we need to we are using column table to calculate. Okay, from one column to one column to time to divide and so on. But this one is more direct. Okay, we have a look on the example. Okay, example, we are still using the same example like yesterday. Okay, so ABC Senambil Heart is a block work manufacturer. Okay, the top management want to invest RM9,000. Okay, they have two options, whether they want to manufacture new product or they want to produce more of the existing product. So the product will generate income after 4 years. Okay, so the MARR, which is the minimum acceptable rate of return, is at 12%. Calculate the MPDR ni yang semalam punya lah. So now you have to calculate the payback period and also ARR, okay, accounting rate of return. Okay, so this is the estimated cash flow for each product lah. Okay, we are still using the same scenario like yesterday. Okay, the same example for like yesterday, but today we are going to use different method lah. Alright, firstly we are going to use payback period. Okay, first we are going to calculate the payback period for a new product. Okay, if you want to go for a new product, how long we can get back this RM9,000? Okay, if you are using new product, okay, how long it takes to get back your RM9,000? Okay, so the calculate the payback period for this product is if the inflation rate is 5% and the cost of borrowing is 12%. Okay. So this is how you calculate. Yeah, so this is the net cash flow for new product tadi. Okay, ini kita dapat the previous table. Ini modal kita RM9,000. Ini the estimated cash flow for year 1, year 2, year 3 and year 4. Right? So the inflation is 5%. Okay, given in the questions. Right? So this is the second column. Okay, you need to apply this formula 1 plus D. This D is the inflation rate given. In this case, it's 5% lah. Kalau soalan bagi 10 lah. Right, N is the numbers of year lah. Okay, so you apply. So means that's 1 plus 0.05 times N. Okay, untuk first ni 0 lah. Okay, and second ni 1. N ni 1, yang ni N ni 2. Yang ni N ni 3 and the last one is, the N is 4. If you apply this formula, you will get this value. Okay. Using this formula. Okay. So next is cost of borrowing is 12%. So again, we are using the same table. Okay, we are using the same table like yesterday. So in this case, kita is 12%. So kita ambil lah 4 tahun ni. Alright, 0.893 until 4th year, which is 0.636. Okay, take this value and put it in this third column. Okay, put it in the third column. Okay. Okay, so now you have three columns. Column number one is the estimated cash flow you derive from the table. Okay, inflation rate 5%, you have to calculate by applying this formula. Okay, and then cost of borrowing 12%, you obtain this value from the table. Okay, all right, next, the next column, column number four, what you need to do, what we call it as a discount factor. Okay, how you can calculate this discount factor is by applying this formula. Okay, column number 2 times column number 3. Okay, so means that 1 times 1, this 1 times this 1, 1.103 times 1.797, 1.158 times 0.712, 1.216 times 0.636. Okay, so you will get this value. Okay, so that's the next step you need to apply. Then you will get the value of what we call it as a discount factor in column number 4. All right, so next, what you need to do is that you need to calculate the discount cash flow. What we call it as a discount cash flow is column number 1 times column number 4. Okay, so means that negative 9,000 times 1, 480 times 0.938, 3,700 times 0.879, 6,550 times 0.824, 3,780 times 0.774. Okay, so then you will get this answer lah. Okay. Okay, so this is what we call it as a discount cash flow. After that, the last step that you need to apply in calculating the payback period is that you need to apply the cumulative punya calculation. It means that negative Okay. Negative 9,000 plus 450, you will get negative 8,550. And then negative 8,550 ni, you tambah 3,253, 3,205,523, you will get negative 5,297. This value, then you add 5,400, and then you will get 103. So 103, you will add 2,923, and you will get 3,026. Okay, so that's how we apply what we call it as a cumulative calculation. Okay, so dia bersilang. Alright, zigzag. Alright, so after that, you need to identify the in this column, cumulative punya column. Okay, you have to identify the change from negative to positive value. Okay, so as you can see from the first zero starting is of course negative. You spend 9,000 ringgit. Second, first year is still negative. Second year is still negative, but in third year you can see that the value is already positive. Okay, the value is already positive, 103. So as you can see here, there is a change between second year to third year. Okay, so your payback period will be between the second to third year. Okay, so the exact period or time that you will get your capital back is you by applying this formula. Okay. Right. So this is the value the lowest one, which is second lah. Alright, sebab kita tengok perubahan berlaku changing happen between 2 to 3rd year. Okay, so it is between 2 to 3 years. Okay, you cannot put here 3 sebab 3 nanti dia dah lebih daripada 3 tahun. Okay, cannot be. So you need to put the second year. Okay, sebab perubahan tu berlaku daripada tahun kedua ke ketiga. Alright, so you need to put 2 here. Alright, plus take this value for the second year, 5297. Okay. Please ignore the negative value. So in applying this formula, don't use the negative value. Alright, so you ignore the negative value. You just take the amount saja. Alright, divide by 5297 plus 103. Okay, so you apply this formula, you will get 0.98 plus directly 2, you will get 2.98 years. That's the exact period you will get your 9,000 back if you go for a new product. Okay, you ambil masa 2.98 tahun untuk you dapat balik RM9,000 je. Okay, so that's how you apply payback period for new product. Okay, next, we are going to apply this method on existing product. Okay, existing product is still the modal, the capital is 9,000. Inflation rate is still 5%, borrowing is 12%. Okay, so the same concept you apply. Okay, same process tadi. Okay, cash flow ni you get from the equation, estimated cash flow. Okay, you need this one, you calculate inflation using this formula, 1 plus D, quotient N. Ada nak join lagi. Alright, cost of borrowing, column number 3, you get from table because it's 12%. Alright, so then you apply this discount factor formula, column 2 times column 3, so you get this value. Okay, then you need to calculate the discount cash flow. Okay, by applying column number 1 times column number 4. Okay, means that 5,800 times 0.93. you will get what we call it as a discount cash flow, and then you need to apply cumulative negative 9,000. You need to add 5440. You will get this value negative 35660, and then you plus this 2857, you get negative 703. And then from this value, you need to add with the 1648, you will get this value 945. And then 945, you add with 1207. Okay, you will get this value 2152. Okay, still the change occur from second to third year. Okay, masih perubahan yang sama. Okay, from negative to positive. Okay, so the exact period, you can apply this formula, right? To take this value 703, then divide by 703 plus 945. Okay, you apply this formula, you will get 2.43 years. Okay, so if you're using payback period in choosing your option, okay. So based on these two calculation, you will go for existing product. Okay, sebab existing product lebih cepat untuk you dapat modal balik. Tadi untuk new product, it takes 2.98 years. But untuk existing product, it takes 2.43 years. Okay, it's much quicker. So you will go for existing product when you apply if you want to base on result from payback period. Okay, so the last one is ARR, accounting rate of return. Okay, accounting rate of return. Alright, this one, all right. So for ARR, okay, so still using the same scenario, okay, new product and existing product. Okay, cash flow 9,000 on the first starting point. New, okay, first year is 480, and so on. So this one you get it from the table lah. Okay, the question. Okay, the question given ni, you put it in this way, and then you need to calculate the income. To calculate the income, you need to total up all this amount by ignoring the negative value. Okay, same goes to the existing product. You kena tambah ni semua, tapi you kena ignore negative value. Maksudnya bukan tolak. So you kena tambah 9,000 tambah 480 tambah 3700 tambah 6500 tambah 3780. Okay, so you kena ignore the negative value to add all this amount. So you get you will get 14,510 for new product, 12,611 for existing product. Okay, so this is a formula to calculate the ARR. Okay, so your income is 14,510. Your investment is 9,000 ringgit. Okay, this is the amount of money that you invest for this particular project, whether you go for new product or existing product. Okay, so N numbers of years is 4. Okay, so dalam ni case kita 4 tahun. Alright, so kita apply. So untuk product A, which is new product, the ARR value is 14.3%. Okay, so this is a product A. Okay, untuk product B, which is the existing product, okay, income you 12,611 divide by 9,000 times 4, you will get 35%. Okay, so here you go for the higher lah. Okay, the higher the better. So in this case, we are going to go for product A. Okay, we will go for product A because it much higher than product B lah. Okay, so again ada conflict lah. As you can see, if we apply payback period, the result show that you should go for product B, which is existing product. So, tadi payback period dia lebih cepat, dia dapat balik modal. Okay, but untuk ARR, they suggest you to go for product A. Okay, because the rate of return is much higher, 40.3% compared to product B, which is only 35%. Okay, so the summary for our scenario that we have discussed since yesterday sampailah hari ini, which we apply 5 methods based on the problem facing by ABC Sdn Bhd, which is the blockwork manufacturer. Okay, they have an option whether they want to go for the new product or they want to produce more on the existing product based on the RM9,000 given by the top management. Okay, so as you can see in this table, based on the result that we calculated yesterday, NPV, new product, the result is 1,445. While existing product, which is B, is 1,186. So the result suggests you to go for product A, which is new product, untuk NPV. While when then you apply IRR, the result show that product A is 18.4%, product B is 20.2%. So based on the IRR method, the result suggests you to go for product B. Okay, so then we apply MIRR yesterday. Okay, the result show that we should go for product A because it's higher than product B. Okay, product A is 16.24 while product B is only 15.5%. Okay, then today it apply another two methods, PBP, which is payback period. Okay, payback period, it took 2.98 years to get our capital back, while product B only takes 2.43 years to get our capital back. So in this, based on this result of PBP, it suggests you to go for product B, okay, because it's much faster, okay, compared to product A. Then the final method that we apply is ARR, accounting rate of return. Okay, the result suggests us to go for product A lah because it's more higher. Okay, 14.3% compared to product B is only 35%. So here based on the result, kita tengok yang paling banyak adalah A lah. Okay, so based on the result, we would like to advise ABC Sdn Bhd to invest in producing a new product. Okay, but we have a strong justification here. That's why I said yesterday, in order to more confident in making decision, you need to apply as many methods as you can so that you can show to your, maybe your boss ask you to make a decision, and when you give the decision to your boss, perhaps your boss will ask your justification or your reason on why you select that particular option. Okay, so if you have applied all this method, you have a strong reason to convince your boss to go for the option that you choose. Okay, so that's all what we call it as economic assessment.
Doktor.
Yes.
Yang ARR tu kan?
Hmm.
Alah, buka slide balik, Doktor.
Okay.
Yang 9,000 tu.
Yeah.
Kena tambah juga ke? Kalau ke? Tapi kalau tambah semua, ignore the negative, still tak jumpa 14,000. Tapi kalau doktor tambah, tak tambah 9,000 tu, akan jumpa 14,000 tu.
Ya ke?
Ya.
Kena negative. negatif 9,000, tambah tu baru dapat 14,000.
Tapi kan doktor cakap ignore the negative.
Jap, jap, jap. Saya tekan salah, tekan ke kereta ni kot. Sekejap eh. Kosong. Okey, jap. Bukan ignore the negative. Ignore the 9,000 tu. Yes, silap. Okay, saya berbetul kan? For this, apa nama dia ni? ARR ni. In order to calculate the income, you need to ignore the capital, modal. Okay, so means that you hanya tambah this 4 value saja. Okay. Alright, tambah this 4 value only because this is your estimated cash flow. This is your estimated income for the next 4 years. Alright, so ignore this value. RM10,000 ni tak perlu. Tak perlu calculate.
Okay, doktor.
Then you will get 14,510 and this one you will get 12,611. Okay. So cuma yang negatif ignore kat sini lah dalam formula. Alright. Miss tadi.
So kalau macam tahun lain tu dia ada negatif, kita kena ignore negatif ke macam mana?
Tak, tak. Kalau tahun lain mesti kena tambah. Contoh.
Mesti kena tambah.
Contoh dekat existing product ni second year ni is negatif. You kena tambah lah.
Oh, tambah je lah.
Tambah je.
Ignore dan negatif je. Okay.
Tak, bukan. Tak boleh ignore.
Tak payah.
Tak payah ignore.
Tambah juga.
Tambah juga. So maksudnya dia akan jadi tolak lah.
Oh, okay, betul.
Okay, so alright. Sebab maybe dalam certain scenario tahun kedua you tak dapat income, you rugi. Okay, so you kena tolak lah.
Okay. Okay, doktor.
Cuma yang dalam formula je you ignore the negative. Okay?
Okay.
Okay, alright. Lupakan apa yang saya explain awal tadi.
Sini. Okay.
Okay. Any more questions? Jalan okay?
Okay, doktor.
Okay, doktor.
Dah try? Ada sesiapa dah try buat soalan? Exercise?
Belum,
doktor. Belum buat lagi?
Okay. One go.
Belum.
Ya. Yeah.
Revise balik, doktor.
Revise balik. Boleh tengok video?
Oh, kan. Saya revise balik.
Okay.
Dekat.
Tengok balik video kalau tak tu. Apa tadi? Ya. Apa?
Doktor, yang IRR tu
IRR?
IRR. Ada cara lain ke daripada try and error tu?
Tak ada.
Leceh.
Ya. Yeah. Cuma kalau you guna, kalau soalan suruh guna MIRR, you tak perlu try and error. Tapi biasanya soalan exam dia akan suruh guna IRR. MRRR tu saja yang kita boleh guna untuk mengatasi masalah try and error tu. Okay, tapi
tak ada lagi kan?
Tak ada. Itu je satu cara untuk mengelakkan try and error dengan menggunakan MIRR.
Okay, thank you, Dr.
Alright. Lain? Okay, boleh try buat. Lepas ni boleh try try to do it by your own, the exercises. So that from there you can identify your level or understanding on this topic lah. Because I cannot assess one by one. It's quite difficult with this condition lah. So if you don't try yourself, perhaps you cannot see whether you understand or not. Okay? So next week we are going to discuss the answers lah on each question. I think ada 6 soalan tu saya. Ada 6 questions. Alright, then kita discuss bersama-sama. Actually.
Boleh doktor, boleh doktor.
Boleh. Alright, ada soalan lain?
Tak ada doktor.
Okay, kalau tak ada kita akan jumpa next week. Hopefully by next week you have try to do the exercises so that we can discuss together. Okay, for next week we only have class on Wednesday. Okay, Rabu sahaja. So Khamis tu saya bagi you free untuk you buat revision to face your paper 1 on the following week, Wednesday 23rd December. Okay, so I think as yesterday I posted in the group asking about repeaters yang ada masalah on that time and date. So far ada seorang saja yang PM saya yang ada masalah, tapi is solvable, boleh diselesaikan, tak ada masalah yang besar sangat. So means that for the time being we are going to proceed with the date and time lah. Okay, 23 December Rabu. You boleh start access your future to see the question starting at 4 PM, and then you need to submit your answer before 6:15 PM. Okay, and remember answer it in handwriting. Okay, tulis tangan, snap and upload dalam your future. Okay, and next week I will remind again, I will tell you again lah so that you forget about it. Okay, so that's all for today. Okay, thank you for your time and commitment. Take care. See you next week. Alright. Enjoy your happy weekend. Thank you, think sir. Tomorrow is a public holiday. Kalau ada lecturer yang buat kelas, saya tak tahulah. Sepatutnya Selangor lah. Selangor public holiday. Tomorrow. Okay, so sepatutnya tak ada kelas tomorrow. Sepatutnya lah. I'm not sure lah kalau ada lecturer yang nak buat kelas.
Hopefully,
sir. Yang lecturer lain nak buat kelas.
Okay.
Untuk video, of course, saya akan share. Okay, once ready, nanti saya akan inform the class lah, inform the group. Okay, don't worry. Alright, so thank you. Take care. Assalamualaikum.
Assalamualaikum. Thank you, doctor.
Thank you, doctor.
Thank you, doctor.